So from David's orchard to my kitchen, here are some of the amazing heirloom apples that he shared with me, and I'm going to use them in one of my favorite recipes of all time. It is a fresh apple cake with caramel glaze. This cake is so good, you're going to love it. I call it a countertop cake. You know the kind of cake I mean. It's one that stays fresh for days, which means you can put it on the back counter in the kitchen, and when people want a bite, they can go serve themselves. So we all know that caramel and apple are two classic flavors that always go together. Well, in this caramel recipe, the apple is in the caramel. This is made with cider, and it is so easy, and it keeps for up to a month in your refrigerator. This is how we do it. What we have here is a little all-purpose flour, and I'm going to add some leavening in the form of baking soda, a little bit of salt, and then some beautiful spices. I have cinnamon, coriander, and cardamom, and I have a little bit of freshly ground nutmeg. So I sifted these, not necessarily to take out the lumps. When it's mixed in evenly, that means that it's gonna distribute its flavor throughout the batter. Now we're gonna make the wet part of the cake. We have brown sugar, and we have granulated sugar, and we have cooking oil. You can use whatever sort of vegetable oil that you have, but I'm a big fan of grapeseed oil in a recipe. Now we're gonna take the mixer and we're gonna blend this. Why am I using the mixer? Sugar actually performs as a liquid ingredient in a cake. It's why it goes in with the other wet stuff instead of the other dry stuff, and you wanna make sure that you mix this long enough for the sugar to get creamy and soft and dissolve in this oil. And it looks, coincidentally, like applesauce. And when it looks like that, it's time to add the eggs. Now I'm going to beat each egg in one at a time, very well incorporated till there are no traces of the yellow before I add in another one. Okay, so now we have all three eggs in there. The next part is we're going to add the dry ingredients into the wet. And so in about thirds. And then we're gonna beat it on low speed. You don't wanna put any more air in a cake at this point. You're just turning the mixer on enough that that flour is gonna mix into the eggs. All right, so there are the beaters. You know, a smart cook knows to lick the beaters, but a wise cook knows to turn the mixer off first. So even though we've used the mixer, you always want to take a spatula and scrape down the bowl. We have a tiny bit of vanilla, and then we're going to add our apples. I like them a little bit chunky so that they will stay in the cake, that you can see the little different bites of apples. So I'm going to mix these apples in and some walnuts. And then I'm going to stir them in by hand, and with a little elbow grease, every apple chunk is going to be coated in batter. And then it's time to go in the pan. So this cake bakes in a 9x13 pan. It's so full of apples. So that is all of our batter in the pan. And this is gonna go in a fairly low oven, only 325 degrees. This is unfiltered cider. It's important to use the unfiltered because it has more of that fresh, delicious, robust apple flavor. We're gonna put a little bit of brown sugar. This is a little bit of ground cardamom, a pretty healthy pinch of ground cinnamon, and a little bit of mace. And then we're going to put in some bourbon and fresh lemon juice. And we're gonna bring this up to a boil. So I've stirred until all that brown sugar has dissolved, and I'm gonna add two more things. This is a little bit of light corn syrup, and the reason we're adding that is because it will keep the caramel from crystallizing, so it will stay nice and smooth while it cooks. Then the last ingredient is heavy cream. And this should be at a good simmer. Now, what's the difference between a simmer and a boil? A simmer is just gentle little bubbles around the edge of the pan. A boil is an active exploding bubbles. We don't want that. We want this to cook low and slow, so just a gentle simmer for an hour and a half to 2 hours, but it doesn't have to be monitored. It's gonna do its own job without you in the room. So this is caramel alchemy. 2 hours, all of that milky, cidery, spicy stuff condenses and the flavor concentrates, and you wind up with about a cup or a cup and a half of this amazing caramel, and it will stay in a jar in your refrigerator for up to a month. So the last step in this cake is a very simple glaze. We're gonna put in 4 tablespoons of butter, some granulated sugar, and some brown sugar. And we're gonna cook that until the sugars dissolve in the butter and it's good and smooth. Then we're gonna add in some cream. So we're gonna move the pan off the heat and we're gonna stir in some vanilla extract and a big pinch of salt. You know, the salt actually balances some of the sweetness of the caramel and makes it taste even better. So the cake has been out of the oven long enough to cool off to room temperature. And now we're gonna put the glaze, but first we're gonna poke holes in this whole thing. What that's doing is making room for this glaze to go down into the cake. And there we go, we have a glazed cake. I'm gonna put a delicious dollop of this amazing caramel on the plate, and then we're gonna top it with a big hunk of our cake.
It's ready. Yes, it's ready. So just let